Take it! Run! Find a horse! Ride to town, Merc! Tell them what's coming! Warn them!
Run by the moat! There's a path down there! Jump down from the wall and flee!
Left. Talmurg is to the left, along the stream.
Like that boss. Don't make honey.
Flee to Talmberg.
Do not put folk being through
Go.
Me.
They'll kill you all.
Mega left habitus.
Ibala like that fall.
Warn the others. They've torched Scarlet.
Yeah. Mangere te goni. Erto poslach min det tesve.
Tudod, hogy fog végződni?
Someone give him a drink and bring hot wine and bandages. Tell me, boy, who are you and where are you from? What in hell's name happened?
I've come from Scarlet's. They burned it to the ground. Slaughtered everyone.
Who? Who burned it to the ground?
A huge army. They attacked without warning. And they weren't Czechs or Germans either.
Who then?
I don't know. I've never seen armor like it or heard their language. Maybe Tatars?
Tatars, you say?
Yeah.
Well, we'll deal with that later. First, let's have a look at that leg of yours. Grit your teeth, boy. I'm gonna pull that arrow out. Easy. All done. You were lucky, lad. The arrow missed the bone. It only needed bandaging, and I've done that often enough before. War is a good teacher. Can you stand? There you go. Good as new.
Thank you.
If you idlers nothing better to do, get back to work. You'll have to speak to Lord Divish. Can you manage? Sir, this is a survivor from...
I heard, Robart. Tell me, boy, what exactly happened? Did you see the ensigns of the attackers? And were there any more survivors?
Sir, I don't know what army it was, but it was huge. There were dozens of banners flying on the hill above Scarlet's. The ones who did the slaughtering spoke a strange language. They burned Scarlet's to the ground. But a lot of people took refuge in the castle. I wasn't quick enough. And as I fled, they shouted from the battlements that I should come and warn you.
The soldiers the boy didn't recognize. They could be those Cumans of Sigismund's. It said they came to Hungary from the east, and now they're the core of his army. Sacking Gutenberg must have given him a taste for stolen silver.
Skalitz is a small castle, sir. If Sigismund attacks, they can't hold.
Indeed, Sir Robart. And our small garrison would be no help, even if we could risk sending them.
You think we're next in line?
Maybe. What's your name, boy?
I'm Henry, son of the Skalitz blacksmith.
I know him. Did he make it inside the castle? I'm sorry. It's in God's hands now. No one else can help us. Anyway, thank you for risking your neck to warn us. Robard, take care of Henry. Make sure he gets something to eat and some rest.
Yes, sir.
And get all the people inside the gates. We have to prepare for the worst. Make all the necessary arrangements.
As you command, sir.
You've done well, lad. I'm sorry for your loss. You must be all done in. Why don't you go to the kitchen and have a good meal? Sorrow is easier to bear on a...
Please tell me what happened.
I heard about your father.
Something to eat.
Ah, milady. You are fortunate our good lady Stephanie of Talmberg has graced us with a presence.
My lady, I'm honored.
So this is our brave young man. Welcome, lad. Bojena here will take care of you. No doubt you're tired and hungry.
Indeed. How could he not be, poor soul? After everything he's been through, he must be as hungry as a bear. Aren't you, young master? Here you are, then. Eat your fill.
And a little wine to wash it down.
Thank you, my lady.
When you're done, you can go and rest with the grooms in the outer bailey.
No, that won't do, Sir Robard. After all he's been through, he deserves a proper bed. Let him sleep in a lodge in the courtyard.
Certainly, my lady. Young Henry here is overwhelmed by your generosity.
Yes, yes. Thank you, my lady. May God reward you for your kindness.
Eat up now. You're in capable hands, so I'll leave you to it. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, man.
When you've done, you can sleep in the bedchamber of the courtyard lodge. And don't forget to take off those filthy boots before getting into bed.
Oh, damn, I'm tired. Oh.
You're that lad from Scarlet. What in heaven's name happened there?
What the hell was that? I must be going mad.
Today the patrols will be doubled. Keep your eyes peeled. If you see anything out of the ordinary, report it immediately. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
It is I, Henry. Forgive the intrusion. I didn't wake you, boy, did I?
My lady, no, no, not at all. But what brings you here at this hour?
I thought you could do with a little wine. It's just what you need to help you sleep.
My lady, thank you. You really shouldn't. You could have sent a servant.
I was going to. But to tell you the truth, I couldn't sleep either. I thought of you while saying my prayers. How awful it must have been for you. I came to offer you solace, to let you know you're not alone.
Thank you. Thank you kindly.
You're welcome. Now, Henry, I know this is all very new and strange for you, but I want you to feel at home here. You're not to worry about anything except getting better. God knows you've been through a terrible ordeal. I know what it is to be left alone in the world, although your loss is much greater. But with God's help, the pain will ease in time. And it can help to talk about it, if you feel like it.
Might be right, my lady. I'll tell you what happened. It was terrible and unexpected. The day started just like any other. Father sent me into town on some errands. A fellow by the name of Cunnish owed money to Father, who sent me to collect it from him. Only Cunnish had no intention of paying. It got a bit heated, as often happens when there's money involved, but Cunnish still wouldn't cough up the coin. Father was too generous for his own good, letting even a scoundrel like that buy on credit.
Oh.
When I'd done all the errands, I headed back home. I promised Father I'd help him with his work, and I was looking forward to it. He was forging a sword for Sir Radzik. The sword was taking shape when Sir Radzik himself came to have a look at it. He praised Father's work and said that with his smithing skills, he could easily make a living in Prague or Vienna.
You don't say.
But Sigismund's horde was already on the horizon, ready to attack the town. A horde of soldiers was amassed. Pennants flapped in the wind, the armor glinted in the sunlight, and the horses whinnied impatiently. They were waiting for Sigismund to give the command to attack.
How awful.
And then death descended on Scarlet. Father told me to take shelter in the castle while he went to get Mother. She was stranded in the town, surrounded by Sigismund's butchers. And then I saw him knocking down one Cuman after another. I never saw him fight like that. But then the leader of Sigismund's raiding party, a knight in full armor, saw Father and charged at him. He cut down my father without a thought. And then he turned on my mother. And he murdered her in cold blood.
You poor boy. May the Lord have mercy on their souls.
I ran to the castle like our neighbours to take cover, but I didn't make it. I had to find another way to save myself. The men on the battlements called down to me to flee to Talmberg and warn you. I was lucky I knew a concealed path around the castle. I needed a horse to get to the safety of Talmberg and to warn you all.
And with all that was happening, you thought of others like a good Christian.
Then I heard a scream. It was Teresa, the mill wench. She'd been caught by a gang of Cuman savages who planned to violate her. I had Sir Radzik's sword, and even though there were several of them and they were better armed, I had to try and save her. I wanted there to be at least one person I'd helped. And I succeeded, even though it almost cost me my life. After that, I stole a horse from them and rode off.
Like a valiant knight.
I'll never forget the horror. It will haunt me for the rest of my life.
That's terrible. How could something like that happen?
God alone knows why he lets such things happen.
Oh, you poor boy. I understand your grief, but God is not to blame for the ills of this world. That is the work of Satan and those who do his bidding. Those who are corrupted by greed, envy, and pride. You must not lose faith, whatever life brings. Fate has not been merciful to me, and my husband either. Although in comparison to the horrors he went through. I was young when I married my husband. It was my father's wish. Divish was a lot older than I, but a woman must bear her lot. Shortly after our marriage, before I even got a look at Talmberg, the castle was stormed and my husband was imprisoned.
Really?
My husband had some quarrel with Sir Havel Medek of Valdek, who decided to resolve it by force. He stormed the castle, burned down the village of Pribislavitz, and killed many of our men, even the old chamberlain. He imprisoned my husband in the castle and put his own garrison there.
That's awful.
I was barely 18 years old, and all of a sudden, I was left alone with Sir Robert. We didn't know what to do. We went to Prague to appeal to the king and sought help from Divish's friends, but all to no avail. We tried for years, but it seemed I was destined to be left alone and my husband to rot in jail in his own castle.
Years, you say?
7 years. That's how long it took before Havel was condemned as an enemy of the crown. And even then, he refused to surrender the castle and release my husband. In the end, I raised the money to pay a ransom, and only then, by the grace of Lord Jesus, did I finally lay eyes on my husband once more.
7 years. And was Havel punished for it?
Never. And after 7 years, my husband returned to me an infirm old man.
Sir Divish seems like a good, strong man.
Certainly, only he has many concerns. He had to rebuild Talmberg. After he was released, the king appointed him Burgrave of Prague Castle, and he was very busy. He had no time for me at all. But at least we were in the city, and there was something going on. And now, we're here.
My lady, you're still young and beautiful. Your best years are still ahead of you.
Would that that were true, lad. Would it were true. But what am I doing bothering you with this? You have troubles enough of your own. I'll go and let you sleep. I enjoyed our little talk, Henry. Good night, and God bless.
Good night, my lady.
Henry, wake up. You don't want to miss this.
What is it? What's happening?
Come to the battlements. One of our patrols reported a company heading here from Skellets.
I could do with a bite to eat.
Out somewhere until it blows over.
Comberg's a strong castle, though. It can...
Listen up! If it's Sigismund and his army, prepare for the worst. But don't be daunted by their numbers. Heed my commands, and all will end well.
What's going on?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense. Why would Sigismund advance on Talmurg in the night? Especially since he's lost the element of surprise after the raid on Skellets.
Maybe it's not him.
Then who is it? The scouts Jivis sent to Skellets to spy on Sigismund said he'd set up camp and was getting ready to storm the castle. And Sir Radzig is an experienced soldier. He'd surely hold the castle for quite some time. It doesn't make sense.
What else did the spy see?
Not much of anything. Before they could get close enough, this huge storm started. And you were right. Sigismund has a hell of a lot of soldiers, including all manner of mercenaries. An army like that costs a fortune. Well, anyway, we'll find out when they get here, won't we?
Aye, we will.
Good luck to you.
Lucifer and all his minions! Who else, Robert?
Sir Radzig! What a relief!
Is his lordship there with you?
Yes, sir, he is right here.
What are you doing up so late, Divish? At your age, you need a good night's sleep.
Well, Radzig, you didn't exactly pick the best time for an outing either. In a big hurry?
It was a bit of a scramble, all right. Believe it or not, this tempest is a godsend for me and my men. As my old granddad used to say, better a sore throat than a slit throat.
I'd say your grandfather was a wise man. Your messenger told us what happened.
Messenger?
The lad you sent to warn us.
He's alive? He made it to you?
He's here with me. He only got away by the skin of his teeth, though.
Thank God.
A brave young man. But tell me, friend, how on earth did you manage to get away?
Thank God for this tempest. When it began, Sigismund's Tatars crawled into their holes and left the storm in the castle for more clement weather. We were able to sneak out right under their noses. The Lord be praised. We wouldn't have stood a chance against them.
Would you like to spend the night in Tumber?
No, no. When Sigismund finds the castle empty tomorrow, he might come looking for us. We'd only be exposing you to danger. Without me and my men, he has no call to attack you.
What will you do then?
We'll march to Rattai. It's only a short way, and there we'll have a better chance of defense and enough room for all of these people. If Sigismund should come, better bend your knee, Divish. There's no point dying in a battle that's futile.
You're right there.
Is that boy still with you?
I'm here, sir.
You have courage, lad. That I can't deny. I am sorry about what happened. Would you care to join us?
I'd like to, sir, but first I have to return to Skellets.
Are you mad? What do you want there?
I can't leave my mother and father. I won't leave their corpses rotting in the street. I'll join you once I've taken care of them.
Don't even think of going back there, you donkey. Are you tired of living?
But sir...
Quiet! I'm sorry about your father, but getting killed as well won't help him. Divish? Make sure that lad doesn't budge from Talmberg until things quieten down.
Not to worry, friend. Anyway, he's injured and needs to recover. I'll lock him up here as if he were Havel of Baldic.
I've seen you've grown a thick skin since your tribulation, sir. But thank you. We'll meet again when circumstances are more favorable. Farewell.
Farewell, friend, and good fortune. Give my regards to Sir Hanish.
I will, and good luck to you and your people, too. These are dark times. Move out!
Tonight we'll have triple patrols. Sort out the watches between you as always. And if I catch anyone boozing, playing dice or slacking off, I'll personally break every bone in his body. I want you to keep a close eye on everything you have.
What is it you need?
I could use an extra pair of eyes, and yours are keen. Will you keep watch on the battlements with my men?
Is that a request or an order?
I'd rather it was a request you answered yes to.
Of course I'll help. I have to pay you back somehow after all you've done for me.
Splendid! And don't worry, I'll tell the men to relieve you later. Good luck to you.
Jesus Christ be praised.
What do you think about the Skalitz folk managing to slip away like that?
I can't imagine how they did it. The more I think about it, they was either blessed or Sigismund's mercenary army ain't up to much. When you're on camp...
You only say that because you never saw them attack.
Aye. Well, it's a shame your folks couldn't be saved.
Is the robot really that tough?
Tough?
Wandering around like a stray sheep. Must be your first watch, eh? I don't think anything much will be happening today. You can just lean against the wall and wait till morning. I'll show you what's what.
I will. Thank you.
My respects to you.
What do you think about how the Skalitz folk managed to flee the siege?
Thank the Lord. I thought it was Sigismund descending on us.
It seems everyone thought that.
Well, we were all expecting the... And come he will, of that I'm sure. By the way, Henry...
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
God be with
you. What do you think about that...
I'm glad them people...
Maybe he'll leave town, but...
Maybe. Two birds with one...
Reckon we'll see soon enough, won't...
By the way, Henry, I was sorry to hear about you.
Good health.
What do you think of...
I'd say...
He was lucky.
But that's...
What do you think of...
May the Lord watch over you.
Everyone to the Bailey Battlement. Quickly, we have visitors.
Self-appointed king wins the love and respect of his loyal subjects.
Indeed, Robard. Sigismund of Luxembourg has a rare talent for winning people over to his cause. We may be in for a surprise. I don't think he will set his heathen dogs on us today.
Greetings, Lord of Tomberg.
That's the bastard who led the attack at Scarlet and killed my parents.
Don't be an idiot. Do you want to end up like them?
I am Sir Markvart von Aulitz. I come in the name of Sigismund of Luxembourg, King of Hungary and Croatia, who has resolved to strike against those who disrupt concord in the land and to restore order in the name of his brother, King Wenceslaus IV.
Restore order? By burning and pillaging the king's estates.
Greetings, Sir Markvart. The efforts of the king's brother to bring order to this chaotic land are undoubtedly noble. It seems to me, though, that he and his army have somewhat strayed. As Burgrave of Prague Castle, I am entirely beholden to the king. And here in Taumburg, divine peace reigned until your arrival. To what, then, do we owe the honor of your visit?
Yesterday, His Majesty took action against the enemy of the kingdom, Sir Radzig Kobila, who has been using the silver from the Scarlet's mine to fund insurrection against the crown. Unfortunately, the insurgent escaped. Would you happen to know noble, sir, where he might be at this time.
As far as I know, the Sir Radzik of which you speak is the king's hetman at Skalitz. I find it hard to imagine that he would rebel against our king. Nevertheless, I can assure you that Sir Radzik is not at Talmberg. He would be a fool indeed to flee from one castle, where he has little chance of defense, to another, where he has even less. Or do you take the view that my humble manner is any obstacle to your army?
Am I to inform the king, then, that Sir Radzik Kobila is not at Talmberg, and that he has your loyalty?
Sir Radzik Kobila is not here, and I have no intentions of getting embroiled in affairs from which I have nothing to gain.
Very well, sir. As you wish. I will relay your words to the king in the hope he will be as well disposed as you seem to be.
Those who have clean consciences and goodwill may find themselves well disposed even at moments like this, when there is little cause for joy. Farewell, sir.
Auf Wiedersehen.
My lord, you have my utmost admiration.
Get on with you, Robard.
My respects to you.
Can we trade?
If you've got...
Take care now.
What are you doing? There's people walking here.
Good day to you.
I need to get out.
Says who?
I'm not trying to...
Do you think I'm a...
Damn it.
On the other hand... Well,
agree?
That's not enough. Now,
God be with you.
Yeah.
to wait for me here, friend. Better to keep going on my own. Looks like they've already gone.
What's going on?
Well now, look what's come crawling out from under some rock. Yeah.
Go ahead and gather your strength.
Don't need it.
Here.
Gone weak at the knees, have you? Fuck it. Down! This won't take long.
What's that? Answer to my prayers. Yeah. Fucker. What's the matter? Lost your ball? Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
You stood by his side and he did this to you. In the end, you were a hero. You didn't run away. Didn't abandon like me.
Why did he do it to me, Father? Why? Why did you leave me? Forgive me. Forgive me for everything. Next time I won't run. I'll never run away again. His face. I'll find him. But first, I have to find the shovel and take care of you. I remember you told me you wanted to lie beside Mother. Here, under the linden tree. At least I can do that much for you.
This is a good place. You're gonna like it here.
away, you mutt! Get away, you beast!
What's going on? Smithshack, what in God's name are you doing?
What do you think I'm doing? Digging turnips? The beast just went for me.
Isn't that Mutt the butcher's Mutt? And isn't that body the butcher's?
Yeah, that's him. What's that got to do with anything?
Seems to me that dog knows exactly why he's going for you. You're picking dead men's pockets.
What do you care what I'm doing here? What are you doing?
I asked what you're doing here. How about you give me an answer?
If I want to confess, I'll go to the priest. Go away and leave me in peace.
Do you know what happened to Teresa from the mill? When I fled, the Cumans wanted to. They meant to violate her. God knows what else.
No, I don't know. What do I care? They probably raped her and killed her like all the others. Her misfortune. Right now, I've got to take care of myself.
How did you manage to get away?
How do you think? I ran.
Would you lend me that spade? I have to dig a grave, and I can't find another.
What's it worth to you? I see you have a fine sword. I'll gladly trade you my spade for that. How did you come by it, anyway?
My father forged it for Sir Radzik. It's my duty to deliver it to him. It's not for sale.
Go right ahead. And dig that grave with your sword. See how that... And where will you dig it anyway? Here? You're not going to lay your parents in unhallowed ground, are you?
Father said he wanted to be buried here, and I can't take him to St. James's. God willing, later I can find a priest to consecrate the ground. I've interrupted you robbing the dead. Is that why you're so ill-tempered? You bastard. Haven't you got a shred of honor?
And what of it? The butcher has no more need of coin. And now that I think of it, your sword would do me quite nicely as well. Will you hand it over without a fuss, or do you want to end up like the butcher here?
The only way you'll touch this sword is when I shove it in your guts.
So that's the way of it? Not without a sword?
I know this goblet.
It belongs to Beron. But who knows? Maybe he managed to get away. Now what? Thank you.
So, let's get to it. Damn it all. How am I gonna do this?
Do you need some help?
Is that him?
Yes. Can't you see the sword?
Who are you? What do you want?
Zbyszek?
Who do you think we are? Franciscan brothers? We're to rob you of everything you've got. Especially that fine blade that's of no use to a peasant like you anyway.
Banish the thought. It is my father's sword.
You mean him? I don't think he's going to be needing it anymore. Listen here, boy. You hand over that sword, I might just let you go. If not, you're in for a family reunion you really don't want.
Leave me alone.
Kill him, Runt! Aye, cut the bastard down.
As you like. Could have just cost you a few teeth. I told you how it would end. You should have listened to me. This is nice work. The chief is going to like it. It's new, isn't it? And now, for the maiden bloodletting. Surely your father never would have imagined it would be your blood. I believe there's a word for such moments. The old man would certainly know. But I'm just a common killer. Did you help make it? No doubt you did. Such miserable luck. To die by the sword you helped forge.
Hey, go fuckers! The games are over.
Don't! Disperse this rubble!
Thank you.
Do you need some help?
Wake up, Henry. It's past sunrise.
Henry, can you hear me?
Get up, Henry. Wake up. It's a new day.
Henry, can you hear me? Hallelujah. I thought you'd never wake. Were you having a nightmare?
Teresa?
You still have a fever. Uncle won't be pleased, but you'll have to stay in bed.
Where am I? In Scallets?
We're at my uncle's mill in Rattay. I didn't know where else to go.
What happened?
You don't remember anything? I suppose that's not surprising. I found you in Scallets after those bandits attacked you. I thought they'd done for you, but you were still breathing. Why in heaven's name did you go back there? It was madness. They slaughtered everyone who didn't run.
My parents, I wanted to bury them. I had to...
Don't worry. I took care of it.
Thank you.
Any good Christian would have done the same. Now sleep. You need your strength back. You're awake.
Good morning.
It's near midnight. You've slept all day.
Oh, I feel like a horse fell on me.
The beating you took was worse. But at least the fever's broken.
How
How did you manage to save me?
You were lucky. I was in Skeleton and I saw Zbyshek and his thugs. I tried to distract them, but it would have been no use if those soldiers from Tamburg hadn't arrived. They were searching for you and scattered the bandits.
What in the world were you doing in Skalitz?
Waiting to die.
What?
They killed my brothers, my family, my friends.
They're all dead.
All of them. Everyone I ever loved. They killed one of my brothers in the mines. After that, what did I have to live for?
Don't say that. There's always hope.
No, there isn't. But it doesn't matter. I'm a different person now.
Searching for me?
Yes. Lord Divish sent them, led by Captain Robart. So tell me, why is a lord of such high standing interested in a blacksmith?
Sir Divish promised Sir Radzik he'd look after me. But as for why they should care, I've no idea. Oh, I'm exhausted.
I'm not surprised. I'll bring you water and something to eat. In the meantime, rest. You're still very weak. Good morning to you. How's the invalid today?
I haven't felt as good as this since they lashed me to the wheel and quartered me on the town square.
Got your sense of humour back. You must be better. My uncle will be glad to hear it. I had a job persuading him to let me bring you here. If you'd lain around much longer, he really would have dumped you on the town square. You can stay until you find somewhere else to live, but my uncle will want payment for taking you in and caring for you.
And this is your uncle's house?
We're in Rattay Mill. My uncle's Miller Peshek. He took me in, and I talked him into taking care of you too.
I've been lying here long enough.
Uncle will be pleased he's one mouth less to feed. But are you truly well enough?
Well enough to do what has to be done. Where can I find Sir Radzik?
He's in the lower castle in Perkstein. He's a guest of Sir Hanish of Lipa. But someone like you can't just walk up bold as you please and demand an audience.
I know Sir Radzik, and I didn't bring him his sword as I was supposed to. I must see him.
If you insist, but you need to speak to my uncle first. You've been in your sickbed for over a fortnight while he paid the apothecary to tend to you, and for medicine. That's a good deal of a coin you owe him.
I've been lying here 2 weeks. My God.
Better a fortnight in bed than an eternity in the grave. If it weren't for my uncle, you wouldn't be here at all.
I owe you both my life, and I'll repay my debt. You have my word.
All right. But before you go to town, you should eat something. You're still weak. There's food on the table for you.
Have you eaten yet?
Yes, it was...
I did. My humble.
I'd like to.
So, what are you in?
Get myself fit.
That can be arranged.
Fine.
I'm sure you'll be extreme. May the Lord watch.
With you, young fellow.
My name's Henry.
My name's Peshe, and talking of you, while you were lying here, that quack doesn't come.
I see.
You won't pay for that. If you prove to me you're a clever lad.
Look, couldn't I just pay you?
I'd say you're a.
I don't have that much.
Then come back when you have.
Tell me about it.
A trifle. Just to take something from someone and bring it to someone else. And not get caught while you're doing it.
That sounds straightforward enough. Except for not get caught, why would anyone want to catch me?
Oh, don't worry. It's just a job like any other. Only this one requires, let's say, the right moral disposition. Do corpses bother you?
No honorable man should touch them. That's the executioner's job.
Did you expect I'd give you a hoe and send you out to the fields? You can dig all right, but somewhere else. I want to know whether you're going to hide behind some stupid fucking scruples, or if you might be useful for more unconventional work.
I was prepared for just about anything, but that's a bit much. But go on, tell me more.
Listen. It's about this ring my mate, Wojciech, the Kohelnitz Miller, had his eye on. Trouble is, they buried the ring by the gibbet, along with the villain they hung while he was wearing it.
Jesus Christ. You want me to dig up a corpse, take a ring from it, and give it to your friend in Kohelnitz? Is nothing sacred to you?
Money first, morals later. That fellow is dead. He won't miss it. Whatever bleeding heart came up with the idea that it's disrespectful to disturb a corpse. Never read the Bible. It's still a human body, only it's missing a soul. Why be disgusted by something created by God?
I think I've already heard more than I need to know. You've got the tongue of the devil himself.
you tried hard enough, I bet you could justify sodomy with a goat.
Watch your mouth, boy. There's a shovel here around the mill somewhere. If there's any problem, come and see me. And here's something on the side to make you dig better.
Thanks. I'll need it. I can't believe I've come to this. Digging up corpses.
Oh, and watch out for the executioner and his hounds. They're pretty savage. And I don't just mean the dogs. You can just throw them some meat. The dogs, that is. But the executioner? Well, don't vex him.
Take care now.
May the Lord watch you. Try unlocking this trunk.
Hold the lockpick in your right hand and use it to feel out the tumbler. Got it? Good. Now turn the whole lock with the blade, but don't stop holding the tumbler with the pick. Otherwise, you'll be fucked and you'll have to start all over. You're a dab hand, Hal. Make something out of you yet. But remember, this trunk's only for practice. With real hands, you have to watch out. Try it a few more times if you like. Then, good luck. Damn.
Can you tell me?
That's all.
Can you tell?
That's all.
May the Lord watch over.
Heavens.
I'm feeling as good as new.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. Would you teach me more? Certainly.
I'd like to practice.
All right.
Isn't that quite... Is this enough?
Well, now. Agreed. Jesus Christ, be...
I'd like to dis...
Why not?
What about...
Aye, that would...
I'm honored that you should come to me.
Good luck to you. May the Lord watch over you.
Bread! Bread!
I see you, sir.
Aren't you obs-
You still owe me. Don't think I've forgotten.
I don't owe you. I owe your father, and he's dead. So get out of here!
Do you really want to make me angry? Do you really think that's wise?
No, I don't. Fine, I owe you. And what am I supposed to do about it? You think you'll get anything from me? Look at what I've got! But maybe I could... Maybe I could tell you where you can find some money. If you forgive my debt, that is.
All right, then. Start talking.
No. First, I want you to swear you won't be demanding anything else from me.
Very well, then. Talk.
When we were running from Scalette's, I heard something. I don't know who said it. It's a miracle I could even hear it in that chaos. Either way, somebody hid a lot of coin under a dovecot.
Under the dovecot? A goblet and money, right? I already found that. You'll have to think of something better. And it belongs to old Beren.
But I don't have anything else.
Look out!
Thank you.
Halt! Who are you and where are you going?
I'm Henry, son of the Scallet's blacksmith.
Of course you are, lad. And I'm the Pope. What do you want from his lordship? And what makes you think he'll see you?
Come on, I'm not some peasant. I'm Sir Radzig's blacksmith and I need to speak with him.
It's my job to stop you. Now bugger off.
Maybe a little...
Satisfied?
You won't convince me.
Are we agreed?
Well... Do you think I'm...
Maybe a little...
I'd almost shake... Come now.
I just want to eat and sleep. And fuck.
Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I've got the money.
And I was that job's
sure, I'm on it.
Would you?
Aye. Why? Take care now. I'll stand here. First, you have. Once you've found trash dealing. That's the way. I hardly noticed you were there. I think you're ready to try it out for real. Best practice on drunks and sleeping folk, so you don't end up in jail before you even get started.
Thanks, Pashek.
You're welcome. Good day to you.
Can you tell me some?
There's a couple.
Tell me about Void.
He's young and hot blood. And
what about
another?
Tell me something. Can you? What about the? What do you think? Do you know anything? That's all. I hear you're.
So,
I'd like to.
All right. Now. Hey.
I hear you're able to.
Well.
Will you teach me?
Sir.
I'd like to.
All right. Now.
What are you doing here? I took you for dead.
Oh, it's a long story. But what about you? How did you get out of Scalitz?
You wouldn't believe it. A frightful storm broke that night, and Sigismund's heathens ran back to their camp. They never dreamed Sir Ratzik would use the storm as cover for our escape. The entire village slipped away as quiet as mice while no one watched. In the morning, when those bandits attacked, all they found was an empty castle with an old goat inside. I wish I could have seen their faces.
So do I. You tricked them nicely. See you later.
God be with you.
I think I have something that belongs to you. I found it in Scalitz.
What do you mean?
That's it.
By all the saints, thank you. You don't even know how much you've helped us. And if you know my wife, then you'll know you've just saved my life.
You're welcome.
I don't know what to say. Here, take this at least. I'm poor, but you saved us. Goodbye.
Good day to you.
May the Lord watch over you.
Can we do some?
Aye.
Are we agreed?
Less. This is a waste of.
Take care now.
I'd like to discuss.
Sure.
Satisfied?
That sounds.
My last off.
We're getting there.
Oh.
I hope I can be.
May the Lord watch over you.
I'd like to
Naturally.
What do you say?
That's better. See now.